and his crew were just released from custody. About 30 minutes ago, CNN management spoke with the governor of Minnesota, Tim Walz, who apologized and took responsibility for the arrests, which he called inadvertent. Omar Jimenez is now back doing what he wants to be doing, which is reporting live from downtown Minneapolis. Omar, give us a sense of how you're doing and what you went through.
Well, we're doing okay now. There were a few uneasy moments there, I think is probably the best way to say it. But what we were doing is essentially, we were reporting right outside the Minneapolis Police 3rd Precinct that we saw go up in flames literally hours ago. And when we got to the scene, there was another building completely engulfed. And one of the things we were noting was that there was no law enforcement there. There was no fire department there. This building was just burning while people were all running throughout the street. So once the State Patrol rolled in, along with other local law enforcement as well, the protesters scattered. You could tell everybody was definitely on edge because it has been a very on-edge type of week for the community, but also law enforcement as well, as they've tried to get a handle on the protests that have led to rioting and looting in some cases. So as we moved out of the way for the patrol to, again, move forward and take care of what they needed to do, we felt we were out of the way enough, but clearly, once one person ran past us, we were surrounded and they made the move to initiate an arrest. Now, we never really got a clear answer on why that arrest was actually happening, even though you heard me ask a few times there. And the officer that was walking with me, who again was very cordial throughout this, I asked him, like, hey, what's the deal here? What happened? He said, I'm just following orders. So it's still unclear who gave those orders. But when we got here, we were transported to downtown here to the Hennepin County Public Safety building here. Once we were taken out of the van, we were processed for a little bit, aka they just sort of got our names down, and then we were put back in the van. It seems like they were trying to confer amongst themselves. It sounds like also there were some calls going on behind the scenes as well. Then we were eventually let out, and they gave us our stuff. And we were literally steps from the entrance to the building here. In fact, I think our camera happened to be rolling as it got signal as we were rolling out. We didn't have a chance to turn it off, really, because we were taken away so suddenly. And they were saying, just get off the property and then you're good to go. And we were literally right across the street. And when you talk about just the situation in general, I think for us, I am thankful that it happened on live TV so that you were able to see it. I lived it, and people around the country were able to watch and see how it unfolded, so there's no doubt as to what happened. But no doubt in general that this has been a tough week for the city of Minneapolis. Days into protest now, there are parts of the city that are unrecognizable, and right now, until we see any sort of announcement of charges, it doesn't seem like there's going to be any slowing down from at least the protesting side. So we'll just have to wait and see.
Omar, we're so glad that you and your team are okay. We are so grateful to you for your team's terrific reporting. Thank you, and keep up the great work.